Hello, and how are you all doing today? My name is Savior. I want to thank you so much for joining in. Today we're tuning back in to 7 Days to Die. Just picking up a little bit where we left off. So we're inside the bookstore. I believe it's called Crack-A-Book in this game. And morning has been going on for a little bit. The last video ran a little bit over on time, so I apologize for that. But we're actually going to start. Well, first we want to search this building and just make sure that we get this town looted well and see what we can find. That would be useful for us. But mainly my big plans for today, at least, are to actually try to establish a place where I want to start building, and then see where we can kind of go from there. But I mean, it ultimately just kind of depends on what we find and what happens. Never know. Let's see if we can shoot that guy. So, and we do have that settlement nearby that we can at least try to go to and see if we can find anything worth trading. Try to kill this. Oh my goodness, what a shot. Run shot? Nope. I feel like that one should have. Just club him to death instead. Actually saw another pig, but we'll see. I need to also plan for this day in particular is to create a forge because that's going to allow us to start making metal and things of that sort, which becomes very useful. So let's see if that other pig's nearby. If not, just kind of ignore him. It's not worth. Yeah, I don't see him, so no big deal. We'll just continue on along. Let's see. We'll try to check out this section or this building really quick. It shouldn't take too long. They're a smaller building. And I think I'm going to actually ignore the hotel like I was saying in the last part. Oh, awesome. Leather boots. Aloe vera seed, that'll actually be useful. So it is useful at times to loot those trash piles because you can find some nice stuff. I also forgot I was intending to upgrade my stone axe, but didn't get around to doing that, so we'll have to do that this night. Character's getting a little thirsty. Probably wouldn't be a bad idea for me to make a chest. I'll go put that in my house here after a little bit, and that'll kind of serve as storage. I'll just throw my stuff into it and worry about organizing things later. Ooh, car battery. That'll be nice. There's another safe. Found quite a few safes in the area, which is good. Actually, might be quicker rather than chopping down that door. Let's do this. That's what I like to call improvisation. Oh shoot. Sometimes there's spikes in there, so I'm really happy I didn't fall in that. That's unfortunate. Sometimes there's a workbench in here. And that was obvious I'm gonna wear those. want the puffer coat. I really don't want those, even though they're better defense, just mainly because I think they look stupid. But sometimes there's a workbench in here. Ooh, wow, mechanical parts, that's really good. Which would be really useful for me, because I wouldn't have to make it then, but it doesn't seem like there was one, so we'll have to go without it. Oh, what can I get rid of? Don't need that. Don't need that. Okay. And then check the back really quick. Might as well take that while we're here. Forget if those can stack in your inventory. They can't. Ooh, perfect. So these are crates that you can find in various buildings that usually have something relative to the building it is. So since this is a car place, I hope it's a wrench schematic, but we'll see. Oh my gosh, a chainsaw and an iron garden hoe. That's, I don't need nails right now. Chainsaw's really nice find. The only issue is I don't know the recipe, so I can't like improve it because it's pretty low level, but that's nice. That's a really good find, actually. What can I get rid of? Actually, I'm just going to scrap this for the iron. I don't really have a need for it right now. And then I make my way over to my house. Drop off my stuff. Oh, actually, let's take that while we're here. So we can get the gas from that later for a mini bike. Scrap. Whoops. I wonder if I can upgrade that. I can. Perfect. We'll just leave it there because I'm not anticipating going much beyond. Because I'm planning on moving. But, whoops. Let's see. For the time being, just slap it down in that corner and then going to unload. Oops, need those. Actually, I want those two. And then let's find the other. There should be other animal hide, right? Do I not have more? Now, that's concerning. I thought that I had more hide. Well, actually, let me check back. Because I would like to get. I'd like to get that forge going, that way I can. What do we? Oh man, I have stuff all over the place. Okay, I did throw some. That's cool. Okay. Oh, what's that? Missed that. Okay. Come on. Wasted a little bit more daylight than I would have liked to have done. Okay, perfect. And then check next door. I know I had more, because I had all that meat. I bet I just didn't loot everything from in here or something. Where did I put it all? Huh. Really? So, maybe I really didn't. Okay. So I think I've had all the stuff back there. Well, that's too bad. Okay. Right. Oh, there's an animal that I can get some from at least. Need more arrows though. Try to just ignore that guy. Where the heck did that thing go? Oh my gosh, there's two. What a shot. Nice. Oh my gosh. One's dead. Sweet. I usually never make those long shots. Main thing I'm in need of is the animal hide. Just an expert bowmaster, I guess. I don't know. Sure where that guy was at, but definitely heard someone. There he is. Try to ignore him for now. Oh shoot, I do have meat on me though. They're gonna be smelling me. Alright, so let's see. What kind of terrain we've got up here. So, more desert. Want to avoid that. Desert goes all along. I don't want to build too far away just because I don't really want to have to make multiple trips back and forth carrying all my stuff over like a long distance. But oh shoot, that reminds me, that's the other thing I'm going to need. There's clay there. Collect some fibers. So this brown like patch is it's clay, which I know I need that for my forge, as well as for cobblestone. I believe you need clay for cobblestone. Maybe I'm wrong, but I know you need it for other stuff later on, so clay, it's important to have at least. Let's make more arrows and actually let's do some skill points. It's a really good one to have. There we go. Gotta level up some more so I can get some more skill points. So yeah, there are like role-playing elements to where you level up and get skills and put them into stuff, and so I don't know. There are ones that I think are good to have early on, and some that are more beneficial later. So that's kind of, I mean, it's up to you. It's whoever's playing, your own style and how you like to play. But I think that like the ones that help with the stamina and things are really good to get early on, as well as like the ones that help you gather more resources when you mine, things like that. Gather resources quicker, things like that. Those are really helpful. But guy's getting thirsty. Probably get one more block of it, and then we'll head back to the house temporarily. Oh, well, that's too bad. Let's see. On. Right, we got it. Want to do one more? I lied, just because I had to make a whole new shovel, so might as well get some use out of it. And then, actually, we're getting kind of low on wood and rocks, so. Let's get the forge going. That way, I can get some metal starting to smelt, and that's what I need clay for, smelting the. Remember now? Okay. So, you do need clay when you're making iron and things of that sort. So, clay's good to have for that. And basically, the way the forges work are like, you put the resources in there as it turns on, and it sort of becomes its own inventory of what you have in the furnace, so it like takes time that it has to like burn down the resources, and then they basically are like permanently in that, well, I guess not permanent, but they're placed within that forage resource, so like it's like each raw iron's worth like 5 iron in the forge and things like that, so it's not like you have to get a ton of resources, but because eventually you get them filled up like thousands and thousands of clay and things like that. And but it's like you get 5 clay in the forge for every one that you smelt. So yeah, if that makes sense, it's probably ridiculously confusing, but nonetheless, let's see. First, I'm gonna drink water. That way, my guy's not dying. And then, actually, probably not a bad idea to keep those jars to fill up later. And then, actually want to try to make sure that I didn't make like a bellows or something already, because that would really be unfortunate if I did and I forgot and just started doing all this. So I'm gonna combine all of my stuff together, get it there. And what's in here? Some tallow. We can scrap that. Plus, it helps when you have all of your resources lumped together. That way, you get like a broader picture of what you have. Actually, I'm gonna place some light sources down. That way, I can actually see. Because I have them, so I might as well use them. So, yeah, that's everything. So now I need to make bellows. What do I need? Iron pipe. So once that's done, then I need forge, need the bellows, do need lump of clay, need more stone, and then that iron pipe. Wow, just enough. Okay, so I need to go get some stone. Actually, we're gonna have to go get a lot of stone. So maybe I'll travel over that way. Let's see, there's a deer too. Travel over that way and see what I can't find to help out a little bit with finding a safer area to build a house. Don't know. I might not want to place my forge until I find, like, start building a permanent home. I don't know for sure. Because that also might take a little bit, so maybe I will. Okay, we have the bellows. Now we're gonna start crafting the forge. And we'll try to go get that deer really quick, because having more meat's always a good thing. Actually, we could probably use some more wood too, I think. Yep. Time being, collect some fibers. So you always are going to need fibers for different stuff. We'll finish up this last piece of this rock and then go get some wood, get that deer, and then try to start up our forge. Good thing is we're getting some raw iron from these rocks too, so that'll help. Oh, where did that deer go? Maybe I won't get that deer. Guy's overheating, I guess. This is a slow process of collecting wood with this axe, so. Right, we'll head back. Let's put this right there. So, wood goes in the fuel slot, actually. There we go, much quicker. And then put all that clay in there. Going to need to make an anvil first. There it is. So, as you can see, it starts going up. Get my other iron from here and toss it in. While that's gone, see, go collect some water. Make a bunch of those because I want my iron axes to be higher level. That way, they actually help me out a little bit more. Because lower level iron axes are kind of worthless. Believe that there was water over this way. Believe. Yep, there we go. Guy's getting a little hungry too. Come on. There we go. Nice. Leveled up again. So we're on to. We'll get that one. That one's really nice to have for mining and things of that sort. Then. There we go. And all those are scrapped. Make another bundle of them. Try to collect some fibers so we don't run out. So that also wouldn't be good. So now I lose a little less stamina because of that perk I bought when I mine things. And I do a little bit more block damage, which I believe allows me to get more resources out of it quicker. Think, at least. It's too bad there wasn't a workbench in there. That could have really helped me out. That's okay. This is just another prep day of getting established to get ready to build my own base. It's kind of the way I prefer to start out in this game, is not necessarily just on the first night building up, you know, a cheap little wood base and, you know, upgrading from there. I like to find something that already exists and just kind of hunker down for a little bit. And then from that, there we go, and craft an anvil. But from that, then, you know, gathering enough resources and things to start off with making a base that's a little bit stronger. So that's my hope, at least. And like I said, we're just kind of playing it for fun. There's no real goal in mind. It's kind of trying to do something enjoyable for people to watch, and I just like playing the game in general, so it's fun for me. Oh yeah, one thing we can do. Put some wood in there. Make that into water. I do, actually. Let's see. Once that anvil's done, I'm gonna make a cooking grill, so then I can eat. I might try to mine in the middle of the night, get some more wood and rock and things, because I could use some of that. A little low on those resources. But we'll see what we can do. I also don't want to run the risk of dying in the middle of the night. That's not good either. It's almost there. Wonder if my open sign turns on. It is not. Huh. Wonder how you make it turn on. I would love it for mine to be turned on. That'd be awesome. One thing at a time, I guess. I think there is a way that you can actually get signs like that and like transport them if you find like a wrench, which I'm actually surprised I haven't found yet. Wrenches are really important though and help out a lot. Just with collecting different things and really good to have. There we go, finally getting the stone axe level up. I think another bundle of 15, we might hit 100 as long as it keeps doing one at a time. But one level at a time, I should say. Yeah, there we go. And then, so we have that grill. Now, if I put this in the fire, oops, I have to turn that off. I was locked because of that. There we go. Now, cook the rest of the water, and then get the meat, get some eggs. Because you can make bacon and eggs. And then I'm gonna do like 10 grilled meat. Because grilled works better than charred. You can grill with the cooking grill, and it has a lot more benefits for you. But that'll be at least enough to help out for a little bit now. And then as that's going, actually, do we have any? Ooh, we do. Takes 20 iron to make like an axe or a pickaxe, so we can do that. Ooh, it looks like we'll be just shy. Actually, I don't need that stone shovel either. There we go. Try to make like 10 more. That way we can get the level up above 100. And then we have that going. Let's see if we have any food yet that way. I am at 1%. Oh wow. Got an achievement for, I believe that's traveling like distance. Yeah, 250 kilometers. That's awesome. There we go. Bacon and eggs. So like really good food like this increases your wellness, which your wellness, basically every wellness that increases, you gain another stamina and max health. So that's really beneficial. So now I'm above 100 each. So that's really nice. I don't know exact because it says it gives you plus one wellness, but obviously eating that one didn't increase it. That one did. So I don't know exactly what the ratio is of increasing your cap. But the grilled meat, the only downside is you do become a little thirsty. But that's okay, because I have tons of water. There. And like I said, I'm gonna try to sort out my items and stuff eventually, but oops, right now it's not really a priority. Because a couple more seconds and then we'll have this. Once I get. Oh wait, we ran out of iron. That's too bad. Is there anything? Those are iron. I can throw those in there. Let's start off with iron pickaxe. So it does take 3 minutes, but that's okay. We'll get it shortly. And then, which I can increase that, like over time, there's skills that you can get that will increase the length of time that it takes to make things. So that'll be nice. do still have some clay going. I'll split it in half, that way it kind of speeds up the process since I don't have anything else in there. Oops, wasn't done yet. Try to save a little bit of my wood. Not using it all up. Guess I could take this tallow and make a torch. Oops. Let's take cloth. I always forget that. We're a little low on our cloth, too. We'll go outside while we're making that pick and try to at least collect some wood. Guess since there's this tree here, we'll start there. So using the stone axe actually does qualify as a construction tool because it's what you use to repair and things like that. So that's why you see that I level up my construction tools when hitting stuff with this, but you'll see with like the iron pickaxe, it'll actually will, I believe it's just called like mining tools. They'll be leveling up. So it's important to use both. Still not a ton of resources at once that I'm collecting, but it's all right. 40 more seconds. We're getting there. Like I said, this was just planning. I was planning on this just being a prep day for getting ready with resources and things like that. So the and obviously like the forge was a main goal for today, and so we accomplished that. So that's good. Because my main plan was to get enough resources and things like that so I could get metal tools so I could gather resources better and then make my base and things. Because, starting up day three now, and then that'll only leave us a few more days to go before the 7 day horde. So we're getting there, but I think we'll be ready. My goal is to have a cobblestone structure of some sorts to live in. I don't know if that'll look like. My ultimate goal is to have a cobblestone house, and then have that surrounded by a cobblestone wall, with kind of viewpoints to where I can look through. It'll be like sectioned off. It's kind of hard to explain without showing it, but there'll basically be a middle layer that's open so that I can see either the torso or the head of the zombies, so then I can like stand on the other side of the wall and hit them. But yeah, that's at least my plan. So go get some of these rocks with my new awesome metal pickaxe. Can also make it so you guys can see for fun if you want to, see me hit this rock. So it's just quicker, really, is the main thing. Until I start leveling up more, eventually you start g gaining more per hit and things like that, which is really nice. After I get this rock, I'm gonna run inside really quick so I can put this metal I'm collecting back in the forge, and then that way I can get enough iron to make a, I think it's called a fire axe. I basically use it to chop down wood or trees to get wood. Trees are made of wood. See. ran out of stamina there. I do. I don't know. I might go against what I said before and actually try to loot that hotel. Mainly because I would like to find a wrench. That would really help a lot. Particularly a wrench schematic so I can make it. That'd be really helpful, but we'll see what we can do. There we go. Get that going. And then drop off some of this stuff. Let's see. I go mine another rock. Maybe we'll check out that hotel a little bit this evening. Nights are good for, looting and things like that. I don't want to get attacked by a zombie I can't see because it's dark, but it's also part of what happens, I guess. So it's the apocalypse. Plus, we do need more metal, so that'll help. Get some more iron fragments to put in the forge, and then I'll go loot that hotel a little bit. Obviously, not all of it because it's freaking huge, but I think that there's a kitchen on the first floor sometimes. That actually might be a decent place for finding a wrench because I think they're a little bit more likely to spawn in sinks, and so kitchens typically have sinks. So that's a good go-to. I think there might also be bathrooms behind the kitchen, which also has sinks. So we can check that out really quick. Test if my theory is correct. Oops. I thought I heard something, maybe not. Oops, a little bit more to go. Forgot how far along I was. Finish up this section and then go drop it off really quick and then go check out that building. Let's do. Probably gonna want more arrows in case I encounter zombies in there. I hope I don't, but then let's see. Yeah, there we go. Let's make 20 more. That way I can get a fire axe. And then, actually, gonna want some of these. I always like to keep, whenever I'm searching a building, always like to keep some wood frames with me in case, zombies start coming at me. And then I can, place them down and sort of put a wall between me and them. And with that, I can shoot them or do whatever, I guess. Club them in the head if you need to do that. I don't hear any zombies, but except for that noise, whatever the heck that is. But 3 seconds. I want to make sure I have this axe in my quick bar just in case something happens, because this is actually glass, so rather than working on the door, let's block that up behind me. There's more glass, but right. Obviously, we're going for the cash registers first. That's the apocalypse. All right, I think. Oh man, this is in like a swamp. territory. These, actually, these picks work better on iron doors. I forget if these are bathrooms. We'll find out. No, it's an empty room. Sorry. Oh, yes, look, kitchen. So there's some cooking pots. So. And tons of sinks. More cooking pots. That was a wrench. Perfect. I looted it so fast I barely even saw it. So we did get one wrench. That'll be really good. And just one in all these. Actually, those might be leather. They are. I think there's three. Collect leather from these couches. No one needs. Or I guess they're like booths. No one needs a booth anymore. The apocalypse. It's just gonna be my go-to phrase now, I think. I'm not gonna collect all of it, but the idea. Little balcony. Let's go check out that room. So we did get one wrench, level 61. Put that in my quick bar. There we go. There's some cash registers in here. Oh man, this is a little dark. I apologize. It's a little hard to see. But we are actually about to hit morning. And so, beverage coolers. I mean, I did what I wanted to do. I made a forge. I got a wrench, which is a nice addition. Started gathering resources, which was the main goal for this video. So I'm hoping in the next video I can actually, it might be a lot of, you know, gathering resources and things of that sort. So we'll see exactly. Oh man, there's spikes on the other side here. That means there's good loot, right? So yeah, in the next video I'm thinking we'll try to find a place to live and then use my you know, resources I'm going to gather, and then start building. We'll see. That's the plan. I mean, no promise, of course, but yeah. So I'll loot this room, and then I think that might be the end. So, oh, these chairs. You use a wrench on them. You get mechanical parts and some iron and leather. Mechanical parts are super useful, and you can also get them from like refrigerators and filing cabinets and stuff, but actually those chairs are like one of the best ways to get them. I mean, go figure, who knew an office rolling chair is made of mechanical parts, but they are, and so they're really useful. So that was one of, oh, wall safe, that's one of the main reasons, dead zombie, that I wanted. Is that another wall safe? That is. Oh man. Pickaxe will help with breaking all of those safes I found. Yeah, so actually, this was really good that I found this wrench, because all of these office chairs are going to be loaded with mechanical parts. A zombie outside. But I think I'm going to end this video here. It looks like I've almost finished breaking through this, or looting this area, I guess I should say. So I want to thank you guys so much for joining in and watching this video. Hopefully this one's a little bit shorter than the last one, but seriously guys, thank you so much for watching, and like and subscribe to this, like this video and subscribe to the channel if it's something that you've enjoyed and would like to see more of. Feel free to leave comments of things you'd like to see me do in this game, or possibly other games you would love to see me play. But other than that, really, I want to thank you guys so much for tuning in and watching this video, and I will be seeing you guys in the next one.